Welcome to Grow with Angie. I'm Angie, and today I'm going to be showing you how to make your own Kratky, and I'm going to be using a Folgers coffee container. I recommend grabbing any container that you have. Just try and make sure it's food grade plastic if at all possible. If you don't have any type of container like this, then grab yourself a mason jar and I'm gonna show you how to make it all cute just like this one. Kratky is a method that doesn't use any electricity. So in a deep water culture, you might be using an air stone, or in your tall hydroponic systems, you are using wave makers, you're using pumps. There's so many things that go on in those types of systems. Kratky doesn't use anything. Did you know that hydroponics actually started in 600 BC? Gardeners were already trying to figure out how they could grow more without using hard labor outside or just using recycling water instead of waiting for that next rain. About 100 years ago, Dr. William Kratky actually tried to grow 25 huge tomato plants inside of big plastic trash cans. And then along came Bernard Kratky. And that's where we get the name, is actually from Bernard's last name. He got his PhD and his master's in horticulture from Purdue University. And he really streamlined how everything works with the pH levels of the water, the nutrients, having your roots sit out in the air, and it became the Kratky method. So now let's get started and I'll show you how you can make one of your own. What you're going to want to get started with is a Folgers can or any can that the light cannot come in. You're going to want your seeds, your net cup, any type of growing media. I love the rapid rooters, and your lid. Use a Sharpie marker, and even if it's black, you can still see where your ring is. Lay your net cup bottom down into the center and draw a circle around it. Then you can use any kind of an X-Acto knife or a box cutter. If you want to just use this to get started and then grab a pair of scissors, you can go ahead and use scissors as well. Just make sure you're always working away from your fingers so you can poke a little hole. And then if your knife is sharp enough, you should be able to spin it around your hole. And then if you want to do the scissors, whichever you feel more comfortable with, and you're going to cut yourself a circle. And we're starting with the smallest size because we can always take more out from our lid, but we can't add more in. Then you can push your net cup through and see if it's going to fit. And if it's a little snug, that's actually best. But it looks like I want to take out just a little bit more. So now I kind of have an indent of where that net cup was. So I'm just going to remove one side to bring this out a little bit bigger. Then we'll try it again. And then that fits. And you can see it's kind of bent up a little bit, which is good because now you know you have a nice snug fit to your cup. And then this will be popped on like that. The next step is setting all of this part up. You can take your net cup and you can hold it to the inside of your coffee can. And also I made a little black mark. If you can see where my little black mark is, right here. And this will be where the water line will be touching the bottom of that net cup. So when we first get started and we put our growing media in the middle, if this is floating just above the water, then you can use a condiment container to moisten the rapid rooter or the rock wool for the first couple of days or however long it takes to germinate. Once you get some root that's going to come out here, then it will start reaching for the water. When you're first filling this up, you are not going to need any kind of special nutrients or worry about the pH at this time because we're just trying to get the seed to germinate. So I'm gonna be doing some jalapeno peppers. And I'm gonna do probably 2 or 3. And if I have to, I can thin these out at a later date. So we're just gonna drop those in. And then I'm gonna go ahead and fill this up. And then I'll show you how we're gonna wrap that with some saran wrap to kind of make a greenhouse effect. Okay, so you can see my water line is just at my little dot that I created, and the net cup is gonna be floating just above the water, which means you're gonna have to make sure you're keeping this moist for the beginning part of this process. If you're not gonna be able to water this frequently enough, then go ahead and fill it so it's just resting in the water, and that will absorb or wick the water up into it. But I'm going to freehand water them because I want to make sure that I'm keeping an eye on it. So I'm gonna push this right in there, nice snug fit. And then you can use this condiment container, and you're just gonna moisten it. Then if you are using grow lights, I recommend covering the majority of your net cup so you're not encouraging any algae to grow in there. So I'm gonna use my reflective covers. And then I'm gonna grab some saran wrap and let this sit for a couple of days. But then I can easily lift this off. I can add some more water until we start to see a little plant grow. So for the sake of this video, I'm gonna show you a couple different plants at different stages, and you'll get an idea of how this whole system works all the way through. This is a mung bean that I had planted a while ago, and by looking at the net cup, there are no roots being exposed out of this. They are still contained within the growing media or the rapid rooter. If you don't want to continue to pull this out, you can always remove the lid. And there's some really good humidity going on in my water, so that is really giving the good humidity and the water vapor up into the net cup. This is another way to do Kratky, is by using mason jars. Now, because it's clear and it's open, you're going to get light penetrating through and potential algae. And this is the fun part. Find yourself a sock that maybe lost its partner in the dryer, right? We all have those. And you can just slide your sock right up your mason jar and get it nice and snug on the bottom. And then I just find where the heel of your sock is and tuck it down inside, and no one will ever know. And you can be a little fancy with how it's all squished or bound up there. And then use one of these that is actually made for a mason jar. And these were sent to me by a gentleman in the Facebook group, and I will put his Etsy store in the video description below. This just sits right on top of your wide mouth jar. And then I'm actually going to pull this rapid rooter right out of the existing net cup and place it into this one. And of course, I like my reflective covers to, again, make sure no light is even getting in the top. And then this little guy can keep growing on its own inside a different Kratky. Now let's fast forward to a plant that actually has a good root base already. This is one of my cilantro that I'm gonna be moving out of the deep water culture tub. So just remember, when you're doing hydroponics inside the house, you can have that luxury of moving things around without disturbing the root like you would if you were digging in your garden. This time, we're going to make sure that the root is just barely in the water. We still want it to be able to wick the water up into the root. But if you can see up close, there are all of these little roots that are sticking out, and there are little feather type ones up here, and these are your air roots, and they are just going to be drawing in oxygen, and they do not need to be submerged. If this is all submerged in Kratky, you will get root rot. So where this is really white on the bottom, that's what we want to be in the water, and the rest can just stay out of it. So I went ahead and lowered my water level so I know that this will just barely be in the water. But if this is from the very beginning of your seedling to a little tiny plant and then to this stage, your water will be naturally draining as it drinks. I've only lowered the water level because I'm putting in a more mature plant and I don't want it to be fully submerged. Once your plant has established root into the water, then that's when you're going to want to start measuring out your food and your pH and balancing it for whatever your plant needs. Because I'm moving this from a deep water culture tub and it was already set up at a certain level and it's happy, I'm going to go with my EC of 0.9 and my pH in the deep water culture was 7.4. But that was a little high, so I will be lowering that down. And the water temperature in the deep water culture was 70 degrees. So I'm gonna pop this in here and see where we are at. And I am at 0.4 for food, so that needs to come up a little bit. And I'm at 68 degrees for the temperature. That is close enough to the 70. Then we will check the pH. And my pH in my tap water is 801, which again, the 7.4, well, it's actually dropping. The 7.4 was still high, the 7.8882, kind of where it's trying to settle down, is still high. Now, this is where experience and just testing kind of comes in, where you know over time how much you're gonna add. Again, if you were doing the really big stand-up garden towers, this obviously is a lot less water than a 10 gallon or a 14 gallon tank. So we're gonna go ahead and use some of the pH, but I don't want a lot. I'm gonna go probably about 1 milliliter and take that down. Then with my Maxi Grow, if you're using Maxi Grow, it comes with two sides of a scooper, a little and a large. I always use the little. It is so much more control than using the big. But because again, this is such a small container, I'm actually only going to use about half of even the small one and just sprinkle it in. You can use your tester as a stir stick. These are totally waterproof. They float. It depends on what kind you use, but they should be totally waterproof. So I'm just going to give that a little bit of a stir. And my pH dropped quite a bit. It is around 5.5758, which is happy. 5.5 to 6 is kind of where I like it to be. Then we'll check that EC again, and I'm up to 0.7, and in the deep water culture it was 0.9, and I know there's probably some settled in the bottom that floated right down there right away, and it will probably dissolve a little bit later. So I'm close enough right now, and I can check it in a couple of hours just to make sure. Then I'm going to add my lid back, add my cilantro. And then if you want to use the clay pebbles, if you don't think you're going to be moving this plant, I find these to look nice, but they can be annoying because they roll all over the place. So if you want to use these instead of the reflective cover, you can go ahead and do that. Just because sometimes with certain plants, they want to fall over, and this actually does give some pretty good stability. So I just kind of push them in there, make sure they're nice and tight. There's a positive and a negative to these because, you know, they don't stay in place. So that's why I tend to use the reflective covers. Then you can place this either by a window if you don't have grow lights, but if you do have grow lights, I do recommend you use these. If you have grow towers like I do, then you can place this on the floor in front of them. And I would check probably within 24 hours your nutrient level in here, making sure that it has not adjusted and changed where it's really crazy and out of whack. And you can go ahead and rebalance that out at that time. If you have questions or maybe you're a little bit confused on this process, please remember to leave your comments down below in the video. Also, go on Facebook and find the group Grow with Angie. We have lots of members that will be willing to help you and answer your questions, as well as reaching out to me personally. Now that you've learned how to do your own Kratky, let your imagination run wild. There are so many different types of plants that you can grow, and don't be fooled that you have to stay to a 2-inch net cup. You can use 3-inch, 4-inch, 5-inch. People put them in 5-gallon buckets. They put them in tubs. There's so many different things that you can do. Just be creative and start a Kratky.